Well, as a businessman, Richard Sevcik has helped build billion-dollar companies. He's managed thousands of employees, and he says that all leadership requires just two things: character plus common sense. And now he's joining us to explain that. Welcome to the 700 Club,
Richard.
Thank you,
Terry.
It's great to have you here. You say in your book that successful management is both simple and difficult. How is that possible?
Well, it's simple in the sense that there are, I think, basic principles that we need to follow. And, you know, one of the things I love, I've read the Bible most of my life, and one of the things I love is the Bible talks about these principles.
Yes.
So we can learn a lot about business from the Bible. But, you know, there are basic principles. Now, once we understand them, you know, for example, one principle is integrity.
Yes.
You know, be honest. That's not easy, right? That's difficult to live
right.
day after day being, you know, high integrity, no exaggeration, no lying, no cheating. You know, unfortunately, in our society now, there's an epidemic of lying and cheating, and, you know, politicians, businessmen, you know, things of that sort. So, you know, one of the things we need to do is understand we should have high integrity. And then we got to remind ourselves almost on a daily basis that we got to live up to that standard.
Yeah. And is that the difficulty in maintaining consistently the character
yeah,
in our
know,
lives?
It, you know, speaking for myself, you know, as a businessman, it was easy for me, you know, if I was in a meeting and it was my turn to talk, you
yeah.
know, to exaggerate possibly. and, you know, the thing that's really damaging about exaggeration is very often you wind up as an employee or as a contributor, you wind up taking credit for something that somebody else may have done because
yes.
I'm exaggerating
yeah.
now. And that destroys teamwork. So, you know, if you really want to have a strong team, you know, especially as a manager, if you want to have a strong team, what you need to do is be humble.
Yeah.
You need to think about what can I do to help other people?
Mm-hmm.
What can I do to help the team? You know, stop focusing on myself and get yeah. focused on, you know, what's good for this group, what's good for this company, what's good for this ministry, mm-hmm. you know, what's good for my family. You know, focus on other people, you know, be humble. You know, that's what Jesus said, right?
Yeah.
Get our minds and our attention off of ourselves and start thinking about, you know, what's good for the people that we love and that we care about.
You know, you talk about inverting the
yeah, right, yeah.
the structure of management where the leader is at the bottom of the pyramid,
right.
serving those who are at the top. What do you have to consider? What are the important considerations in forming a strong team and in getting behind the people who work for you?
Well, really quickly, you know, what the story behind the inverted org chart is, we had a great founder at Xilinx. His name was Bernie Vonderschmidt, and he was a great guy. He was a very humble guy, very aggressive guy, too, by the way. But what he believed in is that the success of the company was going to depend on the thousands of employees and not, you know, just him, right?
Mm-hmm.
So in every conference room that we had the org chart of the company upside down from traditional. So Bernie would be at the bottom, and the senior management team is at the bottom, and all the individual engineers and, mm-hmm. and the admins and all the people that were doing the real work
yeah.
were on the top. And that was a constant reminder. So as a manager, one of the things I want to do with the team that I'm leading is make sure that they understand, you know, what are the objectives, what are we trying to achieve, and make mm-hmm. sure that they understand that they're the key.
Well, and you know, Richard, there's a popular show on TV right now called Undercover Boss, where the CEO goes out undercover and
right, yeah.
spends time with his employees. And you really see that no matter how great your ideas are
mm-hmm.
at the top of the pile, it's the people who are working for you who have to walk that out in the public.
Right. And you know, I worked for about 10 years, excuse me, at HP, Hewlett Packard,
mm-hmm.
and they had a management phrase called management by walking around.
Mm.
And that was the idea.
Yeah.
You had to, as a manager, you had to get out. You know, if you're leading a team, and if you don't understand what the team members are dealing with, and you don't understand, you know, the kind of problems and the kind of opportunities
yes.
that they have, then you're not going to be a very effective leader. So management by walking around meant that I was going to get out there. I was going to work alongside, you know, different people, understanding their jobs, what they were trying to achieve.
Mm-hmm.
And then as the manager of the group or the leader of the group, I could do a much more effective job at making sure I'm helping them, making sure I'm setting up an environment so that they can be successful.
Yeah.
And you can even apply these principles at home, by the way. You know, leadership also applies to the home. You know, if you're a mom or a father,
sure.
you know, you need to lead your family. And so the same thing, you know better than I do. You got to talk to your teenagers.
Boy.
You got to interact with them, right?
Every
you know,
day.
You got to help them. You know, you got to
yes.
understand what makes them tick, right? You got to understand what motivates them. And then you can work with them and you can lead.
What you talk a lot about numerous character traits in here that are significant in leadership. Is there one that we seem to fall behind on more than others? Would it be integrity or what would it be?
Well, I think in the United States right now, integrity and humility are the two biggies that I think are missing in our society. And I think a lot of it is because the people, you know, the politicians are not basically demonstrating integrity,
boy,
and they're not they're not demonstrating humility. And so I think those are two really missing character traits that we have. But another one, I know in Silicon Valley, where I've worked a lot of my life, another one that's missing is, I'll just call it friendliness or joyfulness.
Yes.
A lot of senior management wind up getting arrogant. They wind up becoming very demanding.
Mm-hmm.
I've been in meetings where senior management will yell at employees.
Yeah.
And that's not the way to lead, right?
Right.
It's just not the way to operate. That's not the way
to... If you're going to form a team, you need to be part of the team,
right? Together we're going to succeed,
exactly.
And together we may fail, and together we're going to grow.
And it's an interesting thing. That is a God concept. The scriptures say that where there's unity, God commands a blessing. So it's an awesome thing to participate in. Well, for more with Richard Sevcik, check out his book. It's called Character Plus Common Sense. If you're a leader, it's a must read. It's available nationwide. And if you're a leader in your home, this is a great way to ensure that you stay there. Thank you so much for being with us. Great to have you here.
Thank you.